And when they say Jesus, there's a sort of hypnotic way that if anybody says Jesus, it means that's a replacement for...
Just you saying it like that is
that's what
creepy.
But they do it. Right. They're Jesus.
Right. It's freaky.
And that is a code word. No, that's a code word for meaning I'm your new hypnotist.
Right.
I'm your replacement hypnotist. Yeah. This is what...
It has a shock value.
That's right. Right. It's familiar.
We have a light within us, and it will direct us through knowing. But we've been so conditioned to listen to words and people and...
And get a sense of direction from others.
Everything,
and thinking,
anything.
And taking it to be our own.
Yes.
See,
yes.
A psychotic person will... If you're psychotic...
Okay. A disclaimer, I am not psychotic.
No, but if you are, I will tell you something, and immediately you'll inform me what I said as if it was your own idea.
Like hypnotists.
That's exactly right.
No, I understand.
And so, but most people are psychotic to various degrees.
And what does that mean exactly?
Means that they just listen to others and without questioning anything. For instance, Roy Masters is a wife beater and a cult leader. And everybody in this town believes that. It's been that way for 25 years. But no one asked where it
where
comes
it
up here
from,
to find...
To
no
find out for themselves.
They hold on to it.
Right.
They live in fear. That's what defamation does. So there's something about the spoken word. Since we are all dependent on praise and seeing ourselves in a good light and holding up, putting a nice face on and being rewarded for it, see, and going along to get along and not disturbing the peace. See?
I understand that one.
See, and...
I disturbed the peace as a child, which brought hell on
that's
me.
That's a good thing. My point is, you didn't know how to deal with the hell.
That's why I'm here again today,
right.
35 years later.
So I'm a peace disturber, but I know how to deal with the hell.
That's the difference. That's where I'm. Yeah. I can rock the boat and say, hey, that's not right.
I know, but you can't.
But then when they come back with the arrows, mm-hmm. I don't have the bulletproof vest.
It's okay.
Okay. So yeah, I'm almost in tears over this. So this is my issue. Is I will speak up and speak the truth.
Lovely.
And lately it's been wonderful. My daughter, who was being very impatient and verbally abusive with her children, I spoke up and she embraced it and she thanked me.
That's what you always needed.
And she thanked me and she is really on path.
Isn't that an amazing thing?
I was afraid she'd be mad.
No, some people will.
And that's what I don't know what to do when they're...
No.
Right.
You do it with everybody. Now, you don't do it with a biker who's going to, you know, give him a little cheek.
Yeah. Yeah.
But point is, whatever the situation is, it's never bigger than you if you don't shrink inside and become fearful because something's bigger than you and then freeze.
Right.
Or become angry at it thinking you can be brave, at least I'll attack it.
Right.
That's right. See,
those are all the things.
And
we
then the
do,
other creature says, "But the other creature, being not human, because just because we look human,
I know
we're not human.
I know
we're not human till we're complete with God. We are fallen human beings. Whatever that is, we've got to keep falling and falling and falling, and become like you know, one of those. You look at the deformed human beings on Skid Row. You look at the deformed beings walking in the mall." That's not the same as 50 years ago if you got shots of people walking down the street with dignity. I see America crumble into nothing. There's cruelty everywhere. That doesn't mean to say there wasn't cruelty then, but we were much a higher stature. The nation of much...
We have sunk low.
And we have allowed things to happen because of that little quality of not speaking up. So now the liberals, really communists, sneaking into the schools, sneaking into the positions of power and the universities. They have imposed political correctness on us, and if we say something that is true and it hurts, they consider that a crime.
Well, that's what my point is. An example is those two people that uncovered Acorn.
Yeah.
They were threatened to go to jail for exposing the truth. And so what I think...
And Congress... And Congress never, because there's so many people in Congress in their payroll. So now, you know, the Congress was reticent in not...
Remiss.
Yeah, remiss.
Yes,
remiss and not... actually defended them. And also attacking them with the news media.
That's what we're all up against.
It's painful.
Every one of us that wants to speak up, whether it's to a teacher, whether it's to a child, whether it's to a minister, whether it's to whoever it is.
You must do that.
But we're up against what you know is the minute you do that, you're going to jail. They'll find a loophole, like with those two kids. Well, they illegally taped. Yes, we were doing something wrong, but they illegally taped us, so now they're going to jail, kind of a thing.
Yeah.
I tried to speak up to an officer who was doing something wrong and improper, and he said, you know, shut up or I'm going to cuff you and take you to jail.
Yeah.
What do you do in that moment?
Well, it depends. It would be wise sometimes to
shut up.
But not resent it. There are times when you cannot speak up. It is not wise to speak up. But what you do is resent it and swallow it.
Yes.
And then you have fear.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes.
So you just let him, and there's something about that intimidation, because Obama, his group, they never missed the opportunity of, a crisis. Because they are crisis makers.
And then they want to look like they're crisis savers.
Yeah, but also not only crisis savers, but if you're not saved and you see that through the charade, they feel offended if you speak up. If you speak up, they're offended and they will demoralize you again.
Yes.
They will talk down to you again,
yes,
hoping to upset you into submission, yes, or being ripe to be put in jail or in the mental institution.
Right. Intimidation, so, yeah.
Yeah, and keep you there and keep you berated in jail, because jails, that's where you get more berated, see? So more conditioned, so you never come out of jail better. Those houses of correction are houses of corruption. They don't know how to help anybody. They don't want to help anybody. The guards are worse than the inmates. They're the reason why the inmates are there. They represent the kind of world, you know, the hypocrisy and the cruelty.
They want the system exactly like it is. It's the same with medicine.
They don't want it to go away.
They're getting rich off of it, and it supports the wrong in them.
Well, and medicine's the same way. Medicine has become that way.
So all of the people that are...
Education has become that way.
It's all the same thing with a different title.
Right.
So now...
The whole world is in hypnotic states. And the one principle is intimidation, and your defense is not resent it, because that's the name of the game. Unless they can get you to be resentful, which draws you away from your place with God, your connection.
Exactly.
And displaces it with their...
Because then all the thoughts start coming in, how dare they do this, how dare they do that, and then you use your own will to fight them back, and it's worse.
But, yeah, I got that.
Okay.
But it's got to hear the dynamic. Your resentment is... a gift gone wrong. What I mean by that is that the gift that you have is to discern without a judgment. So you reserve your judgment, so when people do something wrong to you, they may not be wicked people, they just be programmed people.
Puppets.
Yeah, but programmed people who don't know their program are acting out to you what was done to them. They can't help it. They don't want to do that. You don't want to be mean to your kids. You were a rebel. You thought by anger you could rebel. But when you're angry, you're conforming. And, and so it's, see that?
Yes.
Until you've let go of all that, you're going to be the same to your parents, to your own children.
Right. Well, I've grown through that, and now they are coming to the right place.
Well, then,
through my example with their children,
love.
With my grandchildren.
So if you can speak to your daughter, instead of being angry with them for being impatient with their children, which is the way you would have been.
Right.
Because you think that you have a power by your impatience to change things. Yes, you do, for the worse.
Yeah, she uses this energy with her children, and I'm like,
it's awful.
You can say the same thing. She got angry at her daughter. Her daughter did something that put herself in danger, a little six-year-old.
Yeah,
and
but that will set him up to put herself
so
in...
So she said things like, what's wrong with you? Are you out of your mind? Why did you do that? And this horrible energy. So at that moment, I perceived I could not speak up to my daughter.